Good morning, and thank you very much to invite me in this important meeting. And first, sorry for my bad English. If you don't understand me, stop me. I can try to repeat, and if I speak too much, stop me again. And I'm from Italy. I'm a social operator. I'm a president of one anti-trafficking NGO. The name is PIAM. That means a project of integration and welcome from immigrants. We started in 1999, 20 years ago, to open the first shelter for victims of trafficking. In this time, we have a lot of women that come from East of Europe, Albania, Romania, and Russia, for sexual exploitation in the streets. And after 2 or 3 years, they start to arrive the first Nigerian young girl, even exploited in the streets for sexual. And we open our shelter, but we don't know what to do. Because it was a new phenomenon in Europe, the foreign women that come, exploited in the streets, without document. Nobody knows what to do, but we know that we have to do something for help these women that are in bad situation. And we don't know what is trafficking. We don't know what is a Nigerian mafia. We don't know what was a Albanian mafia. And even we don't have any law. But fortunately, in the 1998, our government start to renew the immigration law, and they put one important code, is Article 18, that provide a program of assistance and protection and permit to stay regularly for the women that run away from the trafficker and enter in the protection program. In this way, we open our organization. And now we are in train, our staff is 26 persons, and we are in charge 170 people. We come from a small country in the north side of Italy. Asti is my town, it's 70,000 people, not too much. And you understand me? Okay. And now I will speak about what we are doing now, because we have a lot of service. As Ulrich spoke before, we have good collaboration with the legal clinic, with lawyer, with the hospital, the social service, the police, the anti-mafia investigation team, our local welfare system, for provide all what these people need to be free and independent. And the first time I told you, nobody know what to do. Who know Nigerian girl before in Italy? Who know? Albanian girl in Italy, who knows Russia, Moldova, nobody knows even that Moldova was one state. Then we start very simple, and we do outreach team. With our car, we pass in the streets, we share condom, we provide healthcare assistance for the girls that stay in the streets, and they invite them to come with us in the hospital for check if they are HIV or other sexually transmitted disease. This is a good way for start to have a good relation. And the girls start to trust us, and after we can speak about a girl for more important thing that run away from your trafficker, start to be free. And two of these women, one from Nigeria and one from Moldova, they run, they come in our shelter, and we looked at they are very, very powerful, and then we employ them, and now they are our colleague. I think my stronger colleague is these two women that is now is 20 years that work in Italian anti-trafficking system. And this is a good way to enter in relation with other women that are exploited in prostitution, because one woman that have the same past can have a good way to communication, no? Because they live the same situation. And now we have in our shelter, the 95% is a young Nigerian girl, you know. After the crisis for Libya in the 2004, the flow of the immigrants and the refugees from Libya to Europe started to increase well. And inside this big flow of refugees, Nigerian traffickers put a lot of women, victims of trafficking. In the 2016, IOM spoke that 11,000 Nigerian women, victims of trafficking, entered in Italy from Libya. It's a big number. Before, nobody know. When we start, maybe we have 20 place in our shelter. Now we're 170, because the pressure is too much. And what is Nigerian girl? Poor girl that come from village, from rural area, that don't went to school. Many of them are orphan. Very low, the social low level. Mm? And this girl, they dream a future. They look at WhatsApp, they look at Facebook, look at these big important women in this system. They won't be like them. they dream Europe, US. They won't run away. And a madame, the traffickers, the person that control the exploitation system is a woman, Nigerian woman. They come to in the streets. They meet this poor girl in the joint, maybe that do the sell food or not, and tell, look at me. I was like you before. I was very, very poor. I traveled to Europe. And now, look me, I'm back, I'm very, very rich, important. If you want, if you follow me, you can do the same. This is genius for the trafficker. Because the madame is the real example that in Europe you can make money and go back to be rich. And why the girl cannot, don't have to believe? Because you see the madame, can touch the madame. This important woman with ring gold, with Hilux, with a baby car, speaking with her and tell you, join me, you will be the next. This is the reason why the girl enter, are involved in trafficking. Then after the dream is break in Europe, and maybe is the break before in Libya, with violence, raping, with connection house. But when they reach Italy or other country of Europe, the work is not work. It's sexual exploitation in the streets. And the girl must pay one debt to be free to the madame on 30,000 euro. 35,000 euro. It's a big, big money, eh? And here they start our work to go in the streets, to go in the refugee center where many of these girls are living, attending the commission for take the status of asylum, and speak with them and tell the woman, tell the girl that your madame don't speak with you the truth. The work is prostitution. What's mean? Pay 35,000 euro to your madame in Italian prostitution. 10 euro each man. Must you have to sleep with 3,500 men before that you are free. You think, you understand? Look, you want to do this and an other thing. And then, but we can speak with this girl that if you want, if you join us, if you want to get in our shelter, in our safe house, we can give you protection and we can plan together your future. What is it? Because somebody tell you, come, follow me in Europe. I give you work. With work, you make money. With this money, you stop to be poor. We can speak the same. Join us. We train you. We give you the opportunity to take one work. With work, you make money. With money, you stop to be poor. You and your family. But in a legal way, with your dignity, without spoil your body, without spoil your mind, no? In sure condition. And this is the way that we use too much. In our shelter, we pass maybe, first we have the government give us 1 year or 18 months for give the girl the time for this protection program. If the girl won't go back, we can organize to go back to Nigeria, but it's very, very difficult. But we need the minimum time is 1 year. We cannot take one girl, illiterate, that don't know Europe, don't know nothing about our life, don't have an instrument, and after tell the girl, sorry, now that you are free for your trafficker, go back before your way. This is re-trafficking. The girl shows that is be exploited another time. We need not less than 1 year, and sometimes more, because we have to be sure that when the girl come out from our shelter, is no more exploited, is free, independent. Then we need time. In this time, what you do? Maybe if you ask of this girl, what do you want to do? I won't be singer, I won't dance, I won't, sorry, maybe next year or next 2 years, but now, what do you want to do? Because you need after to come out with your work and salary to be independent. If you won't sing, sing maybe after 2-3 years, but now we have urgency to be real, real. And young girl without school, that don't know the language, another culture of work, another culture of time. African time is a big, big problem in Europe. And we start to speak with the girl, and many of these girls know how to cook. Even they cook before. The kitchen is food is international language. Then we went to our forum of the director of the local forum, of the director of the restaurant, and we start to speak with them. You need a cooker, or you need personnel in the kitchen. They tell us, okay, yes, okay, we can train this girl, and after we can train the girl. The problem was the training, because the chef, Italian chef, when they meet Nigerian girl, cultural, don't have any contact, cannot understand each other, then the program don't go. Then we train one chef to be inside Nigerian culture. Then when he start the lesson, he know who are Nigerian girls, he know what can do with them. At last, with the money of the government even, many of these girls, they start to enter with benefit in the restaurant. And the last year, when I make the account of the last year, the 63% of the girl that we train now is working with regular contact in Italy in the kitchen. I think that is a good result. And another way is that, okay, it's good that now this girl is independent. But it's good even because start to be an example, a model. When one new girl come in the streets and we speak with the girl and join us, run away, forget the story of the madame. Tell me, and maybe the girl can tell me, who are you? Why? And follow me, don't worry. Then maybe we carry the girl in one restaurant to eat together and tell you, look in the kitchen. Look this girl, you know the girl, it's like you. 1 year, she's standing in the streets with like you. Look at her now, she's working. You can be the same. It's the same story that the madame speak with the girl in Nigeria. The girl understands this language. I think that is a good practice. And this is very good because they break the ring of exploitation, this model. Because Nigerian girl, they come in Italy and not at their money. And they make this money after 2 or 3 years of exploitation, they pay the madame, and after start to be independent, they won't be madame. And they work for themselves, take the money and buy other girl and start to be an exploiter and trafficker. In this way, we break the ring of the exploitation. The girl come in Italy, she do what she want, but is outside the bad trafficker or person. I think that this story to make a good model and show the model is the best way to convince the girl to run away and trust us. And for do this, we need, after I have even some picture, a short video about the School of Kitchen, but we show the, my time? Okay, very well. For do this, we need a good professional social operator with high level of qualification, not too much voluntary, we are professional. We have good shelter, and we need money. Without money, we don't know nothing. In my last 5 years, my main work is not to provide service for victim trafficking, but disturb my government to give us money. Because without money, we cannot provide any service. It is important. It's good to have a good law, but the law cannot work alone. It's not that human trafficking is a national problem. It's the government that to provide service for solve this problem. And when we speak about that, I told you before, each woman must pay 35,000 euro. In 2015, they arrived only from Nigeria to Italy, 11,000. That means that the business of Nigerian mafia and trafficking human beings in 1 year is 345 million of euro. And our government, the Italian government, is one of the best in Europe to found and sponsor anti-trafficking program. They spend 19 million of euro, less than the 5% that all the business of Nigeria mafia. This is why we need money, because it's not easy. And you can show me maybe the short video or some picture of the girl. This is the last train that we did some months ago. Oh, you can, maybe you can show some picture, please. Or maybe we can stop here. She's only just Nigerian girl, 20, 21, 18, very young. And this group now is working in a restaurant. Okay, I finish. Thank you.